How do we start this?
Oh, hi guys, welcome back to my podcast. I was about to say YouTube channel.
And welcome to my YouTube channel.
Yeah, so welcome to our podcast and YouTube channel.
This is going to be fun.
I know, right? Oh, this is so much fun. I'm actually doing a YouTube video and a podcast session at the same time with the amazing, the ever pink ones. He's supposed to be like what?
Like, yeah,
like
cool. You feel me?
Cool kid. What are you?
Yeah. First off, I want to apologize for keeping him with you. Like,
oh yeah, no. Let's start. Let's start with that. I remove Myke. After several tensions on his status, add the F1 and the gods. Do not keep to appointments, you people. I remove Myke, kept me waiting for 54 minutes. 54 minutes,
it was less than an 54. Hour late. It was less than 54, like exactly. 47
minutes. I remember it was 47
I apologize for that, but I was busy, like
being pinged.
Not just being like a video that I was editing from like yesterday spilled over to today, so like I was still trying to like put it together. That's why I'll just call you and tell you, oh, like when you call me, but immediately I picked up my phone. I just saw him enter into my room, and I was
as a punctual mentee of ease, you know, as a devoted mentee of ease. I mean, I was here early because I was thinking if I come late, it will start with some motivational stuff. If you want to make it, yeah, that's
no, I'm not like that. See, I'm very chill. Like,
you're chill. You literally have the bedsheets that says that sleep is for the week. You guys, I'll show you.
I'm not laying the bedsheets right now.
He literally has the bedsheets that shows sleep is for the week. What are you telling me? I'm chill. You're not chill or anything. If I'm going to start first, one of the things I actually want us to discuss today was that when I was coming, I was thinking about how people prioritize. We can actually go a long way and just keep talking and just keep making content, going from topic to topic to topic to topic. But I feel like majority about things about life boils down to how we actually prioritize them, you know, how we take them step by step and how this is more important than this. I mean, you literally have like your short stuff here, and I'm on the fourth. I'm fourth on the list, guys. Can you imagine that?
It doesn't.
I'm actually fourth on the list.
I don't organize my to-do list based on. Okay, I kind of organize based on priority, but at the same time, I know like some things don't take a lot of time and some things take a lot of time. So I just like put it down and say, okay, by the end of today, this is what I'm meant to like achieve. So like I just, okay, if I finish this, I'll cross it off my list. Cross it off my list. As far as I can cross like almost like 50% of my list, I feel like I'm good.
I feel bad for Toby. Shah, you're last on the list, Toby. In case you don't know.
No. Toby, we've already made our video, and like our video is going to come out before this video. So
oh wow. Interesting.
So like I plan on editing the video like
can you imagine
going forward before like I edit this one.
So I was just thinking about it that if we have like a system, if we have something for our viewers and listeners to actually have like a strategy for them to prioritize better, it will actually go a long way. Because you see, you find out that your productivity is actually linked to how much you prioritize things that are actually important. See, prioritizing things that are important is like a skill. It's like a superpower, actually, knowing what is important and what's not. There was a time I was so busy doing nothing in my life. I just felt like consistently busy, and I was actually not doing anything, you know. I'm not the kind of person, I'm not disorganized. I'm more of a freelance kind of person. I make an appointment with you by 10 o'clock. Before I go to sleep, I remind myself that tomorrow I have an appointment by 10 o'clock. When I wake up after my devotion, I remind myself an appointment is by 10 o'clock.
So you don't like write it out and like
Exactly. I do a lot of mental notes. I feel like it keeps my brain working, keeps it sharp. Actually, I remove does this whole writing it down. You have content, you write it down. You have stuff to put out, like, you write it down. Vibes.
I'm kind of I believe like our brain normally it's not meant to like store so much information. Yeah. So like I try to like put everything out so that I won't be having this like attention residue. I think that's what they call it.
Okay.
So like when I want to do something, I start thinking about another thing that I'm meant to do. So I know that okay, if I put everything down, I know okay, I can always come back and say, oh yes, I finished doing this thing. I can go over to the next thing instead of like thinking about two things at the same time and worrying that oh, the time may not be enough for this. So I can like try and multitask, which is actually a big myth.
Yeah, don't worry now. You see, this is the thing. I found out that there are always two types of people. So I'm for the other side. Where we just go on vibes, Curtis vibes, man. We just go on vibes, no stress. I'm serious. But if you feel like you keep trying to make a note, you keep trying to be like a real mic and it's difficult, this is the thing. Just take what you can from him. You can't take everything. This guy is too hard, it's too rigid for me.
To be very honest, I don't send your daddy.
Wait, do you think that creativity has to do with freelancing more than just being rigid? Can you be rigid and be creative?
No, creativity is very fluid. You have to be very flexible when you're creative. Exactly. But at the same time, you have to know how to conserve your energy when you're creative, so that you don't get tired. That's one of the reasons why I actually try to organize myself very well and say, oh, okay, if I do this, I know I'm not be tired, so I can still make a video with TIMI.
Yeah.
So. Like, you know,
I get what you're saying, and that's something you guys actually have to watch out for those listening and for those actually watching the video. It's good that you're creative and it's good that you're trying to freelance like me, but one thing I've actually found out is that you can't do everything. And if you're trying to be fluid and creative and trying to freelance like me, and just you're not trying to put down everything from your brain, I'm begging you, you can't do everything. You have to pick, you have to try as much as possible to do what to pick. Be very selective what you give your attention to. Alright. Yeah. So you would not see me on a normal day doing some certain things. It just won't cross my mind. No. I put my mind to the most important things. I found out, alright, if you keep doing things that are not important, you would have a circle of unproductivity. And like it will keep happening and happening.
Over.
You will just wake up. Let me finish this movie. Don't worry, I'll read the
Let
book.
Me just scroll Instagram. And the next thing, you spend like 2-3 hours out of your day, which you are never going to get back, doing what does not really matter.
So let me sound like a remote mic now. I don't use my phone too often. Actually, I freelance, but I have a time I come online to check on WhatsApp messages, and this is what I do. I don't put on my data. I reply them.
Then you put on your data, then you leave.
Then yeah, I leave. Okay. So any message that comes after I've replied, next time I come online.
Exactly.
So
we reply you. I feel that's the best way to answer like WhatsApp messages or
that's,
something.
That's a life hack. Honestly.
you'll be able to, like me, I don't like seeing all those unread chats in anytime I open my WhatsApp.
It's not maturity. Like, those things that you have plenty of red chats.
Like
it's not
maturity. So to me, like it gets me. Even my notifications are even off because like I don't like seeing all those kind of plenty of unread messages. It feels like I have things to do. Meanwhile, they are not really, really things to do. Like they're just things to keep you busy and all. I put on my notifications. Then once if I'm going to this app, I know okay, yes, I'm facing this app. I don't juggle between so many apps. It's not. I'll just end up spending like.
I think I actually just have social media time, you know. Maybe
I think I should start doing that. But
social media time, it keeps me, even though I'm actually more, people see me outside and think that I'm an extrovert, but I really am not. Social media tires me out. Like coming outside and keeping up with energy sometimes with you guys tires me out. I just get back to my bed and I'm so drained out, so
but you recharge very fast because the TIMI I see every day
it tires me out. So but I found out that I was not going to be open with you guys, I was not going to be giving so much advice, I was not going to be talking with so many people like I love to do if I was not going to find a solution to like coming online and like social media and like, and I don't like putting my stores online, I don't like putting my life online. Like I can take pictures and if I don't post it on the day, I take it.
I just called it palliative. that's why I started my Instagram. I recently started posting like my pictures because I noticed that
my Instagram suffers.
Because I noticed that before what I was just doing, either I post a clip from my YouTube video or like I post a quote or something.
And if it's not that,
and
one,
then I just looked at like and someone there's this Dimiji guy. Dimiji, you should check him out. Like if
photographer.
He's a creative. He owns a podcast also, Simple Creative. Wow. That Simple Creative link I sent to you. Yeah, he owns it. And he's also a YouTuber. And
I know that the media is good. The media is good, you guys.
And he one day he just posted stop holding your pictures, something like that. I mean, I just looked at it, I was like, wait, that's true. Like all the pictures just I take normally, like
stop
they're just
duly received.
It's not if I post them on WhatsApp status. It's not if I post them on. So I'm most like, why am I now taking those pictures?
No, most time I send them to my loved ones. Actually, I send them to my clique, my gang. I private bomb. I private flood. I do that a lot. My friends, they.
I appreciate people that do that, but I don't do that. I think I should do that. I just
private flood. Because when I take a picture, I take more than like 15 pictures at the same time, 15 to 20 pictures. So I can't post. If I would not even feel comfortable posting one, so I just flood somebody with 20 pictures. Just since there's no B or something like that now, so I just bomb my friends, man. I just disturb them. Voila for single. All right, that's the thing. Voila for single. But then now let's talk about relationship. I know this is something that everyone really wanted us to talk about. Really wanted us to talk about, and I feel like people actually would really learn from it. What do you think about this whole? This line of thought of in a relationship, there's always an alpha.
An alpha.
Yeah, someone like, that like controls the tide of the relationship, the frequency at which everybody's vibing at in a relationship between the guy and the girl. You get that kind of thing.
Yeah, so, I guess.
So in a case where it's a girl, how does that play out? You know, she was trying to ask me. She was trying to talk to me about it, and I was telling her that I think she's an alpha. I actually think Ebony is an alpha, and like I think most of my friends are actually alphas. I don't go take entire relationships like this. God,
but it seems that they'll end up being with a guy like
another alpha. That's just it.
Maybe not just another alpha, probably they're just people who they are very person. They understand how the person is, and then they just conform, but like. There's a way you just like adapt to the situation that okay, I love this person.
I love an alpha.
And I love how this person is, and so like I don't want to give that up.
Me, I love alpha.
So I would conform to so that we not be having loggerheads at every point in time.
Yeah.
So like you just like calm down, like not calm down per se. You still have your own just a perspective of stuff, but you would always know how to like communicate it and say, oh, this the way you think right now, man. I feel like knocking you, but because of love,
all because of love, darling. I can't knock you, I can't do what I really want to do to you. But this is the thing, this is why I told her. I said, see, the fundamentals of every relationship is actually understanding and communication. You must be able to understand the person you're with and communicate effectively. People actually tend to like break up for so many reasons, but one of the major reasons why people break up is because they actually stop understanding each other. Like, you stop understanding why this person is behaving like this. Like, no man, you are not a fish. Normal human beings don't behave the way you are behaving. Nobody used to dip their bread in their tea again. This is 21st century.
Who does that?
You can't be doing this again. Nobody pressed the toothpaste from the middle. Press it from the back.
Exactly. Nobody feels their tooth brush with toothpaste like from head to toe. Like,
can you imagine?
Actually, I find that very like okay.
What's wrong? Well,
like, are you eating? You're not eating the toothpaste now. Like, you just.
Just press small. But no, some people must press it small. Isha must feel. Why? So I feel like there are some things that definitely. But the funny thing about this kind of thing is that all these kind of people, they still get somebody that understands them. That well, this is cool, man. I can make it work.
If you press it from the middle, like go back and press it from press the bottom, and everything
it
is
works.
Okay.
It works for everybody that way. But please don't try with me, Isha. No, I was seeing something on Twitter, and then the guy was like, "See, cooking is not an essential for marriage, but child, not for me, child, because for me, child, it's an essential. Please,
like,
you must not cook a bag. So,
only if you want to die out of hunger.
Like, please, if I leave this podcast or I leave this particular video without saying that cooking and cleaning is a basic life survival skill, I'll be wrong. You need to know how to do these things. If you can't, it's understandable. What is not understandable is you not wanting to learn.
Exactly.
You
like,
need to learn how to do this.
Cooking is fun. So some people think,
I actually enjoy cooking.
Cleaning sometimes I find it very relaxing. Although some people find it very strenuous, but like when I do all those things, I'm able to think of so many other things. Like I'm not actively putting my whole mind.
Well,
into like washing my clothes or like washing or cleaning up. I'm thinking of other things, but I'm still doing them. So like after everything, I'm like, oh wow, this was tiring but productive and relaxing at the same time.
No, it will be cooking for me. Just seeing the beautiful food in front of me, it helps me think. It opens up my brain. See, I don't say this often. I don't tell many people this, but cooking food makes me happy. You don't understand how much that does, like what it does to me. If you can cook, if you can give me food, you have a special door to my heart. I'm serious. So when I'm cooking and I'm seeing the food, I feel happy. I feel fulfilled. I feel like I can think about that thing. I feel like, see, this is the thing. Creativity for me does not come without food. Once I eat and see,
you have the energy.
Energy to keep going. There are times where I actually want to be really creative. There was a time I had this work I had to do for somebody, and I had to like content create for like this particular magazine, and like they were trying to do something, and they trying to content creating, and they reached out to me at night, and I was supposed to like work on the stuff. I was just hungry. I was just rolling. I wasn't getting it right. And I didn't want to do all this late night food because, you know, I was trying to keep the packs now, you know. So I don't want to do late night.
I
was trying to keep the packs. So I didn't want to do late night eating and all of that and snacking because I just wanted to like keep my healthy habit of eating, because of anything past 11, I'm not eating again. So I had to wait till the next morning, and I just woke up the next morning. I cooked rice, I cooked spag, I cooked indomie. Like plenty. Then I ate, then I slept. Oh, glory to God.
Oh, my God.
Oh, glory. You see, when I woke up, you know, I woke up to start cooking around 7. So I finished cooking everything around 8, 9-ish. So I slept around 10. So by 11 to 12, I was up. Oh, glory to God. I worked from that time, and I walked straight down to like around evening 6-ish, 7-ish.
But my brain
opened up like... Opened up and the standards of my spirit, they popped up.
Food is good.
Food does it for me, honestly.
Food does a lot. Like, people that I don't know, do you miss breakfast like in school?
Oh, yeah. Since I've been in school now, I've not been taking breakfast since forever. Well, since February, I started this whole thing since the beginning of February, not taking breakfast, and see how productive my day will be. So, this is me trying out something. If I will still be creative with this video and making this all of this content,
before we started making the video,
I was very sleepy, and that's the thing that happens when I don't eat. I become very sleepy, very slow. But then there are times where I actually still like put up with a lot of work, and like I still do a lot of work, still like not eating. But since I've been in school, it has actually been very bad. No, since February, it has actually been very bad. I have the worst mornings and the worst afternoons. But by the time I eat, maybe 3-ish, 4-ish,
that funny thing is that when sometimes you want to, there are some days that like, okay, yes, I feel like eating in the morning. I normally eat in the morning, but like there's some days that I overeat. And then I'll just like, oh, let me just rest like a little bit. I'm not really going out of the hostel, and like I'll just have it online, like chills. Let me just lie down. This is my next thing. The day is gone. I wake up by 4 p.m. and I'm like, wow. And I'm training myself not to be a night person. Like, I don't know why. I feel like if I do everything,
it's all the people like I remove. Sleep is for the week.
Sleep is very essential for you. Like
that quote was
a different kind of sleep. You know, there's sleeping and being woke. Like
stay woke, broke.
That quote was like stay woke. Don't like
don't lose that.
But physical sleep is very important. Like don't sleep spiritually.
But then what about mental stress? There was a time in my life where I consistently was so tired, and I felt like it was because I was not sleeping. But actually, I found out at some point I was actually sleeping, but I was just mentally tired. Like I was creating, for other people, not even my stuff. It wasn't even my stuff at this point. Okay, let me say something. In this video, I've actually not created, I've not actually started producing all the content I plan on creating this year. I have all of them in my head, not written out. So sometimes I'm
so
most times I have them, most of them boxed up in my head. Okay, this is what I want to do. Okay, this is one of them, Sha. Let's take this one off the list, Sha. I wanted to make a video with Aremo Mike this year. I want to make a video with Corti. I want to make some YouTube videos with some other people. Like, I want to start some YouTube videos with some people. So, like, I actually planned on doing all of that. But this is what I'm trying to say. I was so mentally tired. Like, my mind was just running and I was just trying to create so much. And I was still not writing this thing out. So, one day, I picked up my notepad on my phone. And I just typed out. Do you know there were just like four things? And I was just so bothered about, so, just four things. It was when I wrote it down, I was like, okay, so this is everything.
So that's
like, okay.
So this would have been beating my brain up.
Oh, wow.
Before I made that What Is Love video, that kind of
video,
like the vlog I'm going to bring out today, I even said it. Like, I was so worked up, I was like, God, like, how, like, would I actually go out and meet people I don't know and talk to them? Or like, and some of them I say no, like, how, like, I was just disturbing my brain about it. But like, when I just started doing that, I was like, it's not even that hard. If they tell me no, I'll tell you, thank you very much. I look for another person. There are so many people involved. So,
actually,
most times when we keep things in our head, like, it seems very large.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, when we decide to, like, break it down into, like, actionable steps, like,
mm-hmm.
smart goals, setting smart
goals. Like, see, that's the thing. Even if you want to freelance, even if you want to be like me, even if you want to just go on vibes and just go with the mood and go with everything, please, as much as possible. You can see your phone notepad, just type it out. It makes it better, actually. Man, I don't have time to be typed, because I feel like if I write it out, I've tried keeping up with journal before, I keep losing the journals, I'll misplace it, I'll forget it somewhere. So I just keep it on my phone. Now I'm so scared of losing this phone, because my life, whole life, it's in the notepad something now, and you can't transfer the notepad app to like somewhere else. So like,
Google Docs or something.
All those kind of things, I'll have been able to transfer it, but then it's on the phone now, and I'm so scared of losing this phone, because this phone has my whole life in it. So,
what if the phone dies? Like,
mm-hmm.
like, you buy a new phone.
That's why I'm scared of buying a new phone. Why do you think I'm scared of buying a new phone?
Like, you can
the only
just
solution I've come up with is just to probably copy and paste each one into a document, then put the old document, then transfer it to the new phone or something. And it's going to be so stressful. Please, I'm begging. Like, try and unload stuff from time to time. Just talk to somebody about it. Make a video, make a funny video about it.
Write about it
if you want. Honestly, it helps.
And sometimes you can decide to cry. Crying relieves stress. Like, I know they say guys don't. Timmy does not cry.
I cry,
but you know the tears know they come out.
I cry
inside. I know that
I'm weeping.
Like, but that's good. Take care of your mental health, like, very important.
Yeah, I'm fooling myself, or I'll be betraying my conscience if I say I don't want to talk about mental health with guys. Something happened with me with this last Valentine, and it really hit me deep that this thing we're actually talking about is actually deeper than we really thought it was. Valentine's Day, I got people stuff. And it's not like I got them stores not because I wanted them to get me stores back, but I found out that at the end of the day, even message I don't get, like, even WhatsApp message I didn't get back. And this is not to like shade any of my friends or something, because I know they love me and we met on that day and all of that, but I found out that guys actually like give so much and receive nothing and like little or nothing back. That energy, like, we rarely get it back, and it's so painful.
I should even make one of my videos. I should go out asking guys,
some
real questions.
It's
like,
so sad, and I can't even lie. It's so sad, because this is the thing now. This is the thing. It's consistently happening, and I didn't feel it. I didn't, like, I used to sit online and like, okay, guys taking care of their babes, and they never get stuff back. They get singlet back, they get boxers back, and all of those things. I didn't know how bad they felt until like it happened to me, and I actually gave out stuff that were thoughtful. I gave out cards and gifts and all of that, and messages, and still I didn't get it back, and it was just really sad. I was just really, really angry. I was not angry, I was just pained. You know, I'm pointing out my heart on your vlog or something. And it's something we need to talk about. Mental health is actually a lot that we need to talk about. With guys, mental health. Guys, protect your mental health. Post to post you. Give to give to you. Crush you, crush you.
But at the same time, you know, love is sacrifice. Like,
yeah, love is sacrificial in its core self.
And I feel like when you genuinely, when you love, and like you give out, or you should not really be expecting much back in return.
No, I don't share that.
I know people are like love is reciprocal, and surely if you love someone, you expect them to love you back. But things are not always like that.
Yeah.
Sometimes both of you may even have different love languages, and like the person would think that they are showing you love, but to you it's just
just there.
Just there, like,
not me.
What do you think you are doing?
What's this supposed to be?
But like that's
I mean, there was a time I sent a very long, before I knew my bestie's love language, I sent a very long epistle in my mind. I was all kids and all that. She just told me, thank you, God bless you.
That's it.
But you see when I got her food, oh my God, she posted on her status, she cried, she was so emotional. I was like, oh wow, so food so was food, it like food was it all along food, like,
and
so food was it all along. She again, so if I don't get my bestie anything, I mean, even for Valentine's, that's what I did. I just got her food. She appreciated it. Like, I reached out. So just know, love language is actually very, very, very important stuff for you to know when it comes to love. When it comes language? To, oh, me, I feel like love language is, oh, I'm shy now. I'm going to drama king. Okay, when it comes to love language, I think it's when I receive gifts, too. Because I rarely do. So it gets me a lot, like, wow, you were so thoughtful. You had me in mind and you got me something, you know? And like, that shows how messed up my mental health is. Like, I don't get it so often, and like when I finally get it, it really messes up my mind. That's why I tell people, please don't call me love, don't call me dear, please comrade. I prefer comrade to me, please. I so I know that no feeling, no nothing attached, please.
No strings attached,
please. Call me comrade, call me boss, call me, you know, king. You know, I know that
my guy.
You see, but guys, don't come and say, oh, my love, please. I'm not your love in the name of Jesus. I beg of you. I beg you, please. And that shows how messed up my mental health is, but I'm working on it. So love, like, words of affirmation gets to me a lot when like someone like goes out of their way to like do all this kind of stuff. And you know, what's the love language?
Mommy, I know Sabi. that's what I'm thinking. I'm like, okay.
Wait, Twitter, I go talk now.
But like, why did I ask that question? Because like, it means I'm like, truly, I've been thinking. I'm like, okay, I don't get gifts a lot too, but like, when you give me a gift, I appreciate it. But
it doesn't really resonate down that much.
I don't think I can touch you because I look like
Olu. If you touch me one time.
At the same time, I don't know. What are they? I think.
Hey, Tata.
What's wrong? He didn't touch you. But like,
you guys just touch his head like this part.
Don't do that. Don't do that. But I think that's it.
Physical touch.
I think so.
With someone you love, yeah. Get you.
I think so. Even though it's not
of hands and just like all those kind of stuff, you know.
Attention.
Yay, actually. Attention, like. Funny thing about guys is that they will tell you that they don't like attention, but
deep down,
90%
deep down, they're crying for it.
They love it.
The truth, everyone is craving attention. Everyone craves the connection.
In different ways.
There are some people that just like I like keeping to myself, but at the same time, I like it when someone goes out of their way to like check up on me, because well, there are just a few people that check up on you.
Yeah, so like, it's just, and I try to do it once in a while. Maybe just pick up my phone. Yeah, hey, what's
up? Have a day.
I mean,
I have 2 days in the month to do that.
Like, just check on folks, like what's up,
like
whatever.
Different friends.
Yeah. And this is what I do. I put up my data, send voice notes on them, and then put it on. But everything says at the same time. This has been a strategy. Like, honestly, when I don't know which you will give now. It's a very much strategy.
God,
honestly,
you're going to do that. Like, your life is just.
You're on your way to success, honestly.
But I'm very sure you have a lot of contacts. Do you have a lot of contacts?
Yeah, I do actually. I just replied to the first thing. If you're not in the first thing, my dear, next time, man, fall in the next thing. But this is what I do actually to solve that. Jokes apart. I archive the chats. I do. I archive everything. Mm-hmm. Then if you send me, maybe by the time it now comes, they are just like 15. So I reply to all the 15 before I put on my data. Then I archive everything. Know if you where that messages will go. Then those that now send the messages next are the ones that I will meet. I archive everything. That's why it looks like there's a message from my birthday last year that I've not replied. Because they were down. And when I got tired, I put it on my status that thank you everybody. So if you not see
much.
I'm sorry. If you love me for who I am, you will know that all those things. You know I love people more than that actually. But this is the thing. Once I archive everybody or I reply to everybody before I put on my data, I archive them. Then the data ushers me a new message and everything. I feel like I just have a mental strategy in my head that just helps me because I'll just randomly remember social person sends me a message. I reply.
Just
go back. Or I search people's names. I'm like, oh, when was that from this person? And I just try to do that. I try to keep up with my friends. That's why I try to keep my circle small.
Yeah.
So I don't have many people, but those 5 to 6 people that are top of my head that okay, if I wake up in the morning, where are these people and where what are they doing with their life? Those are the people like AY.
Mine is very random, like normally the people.
And I randomly remember people too, like Aremu, what's Aremu doing today? Has he dropped a new video? Let me go and check his channel. Okay, watch.
I'm so grateful.
I just been watch. I just one night do night sub, just sit down YouTube. Big watch everything. Oh wow!
Yeah,
this comment.
That's what I do to his podcast.
Just big watch.
I just open up my Google. Just
put it on play. Everything just keeps. Or Instagram too. Like I have so many of my friends that are doing blogs and like so many things on Instagram. So once I find one night to go to Instagram, like yesterday now, I'll just go to their pages, comment, read everything. No, I left Instagram for a whole year. 2020. I left Instagram for a year.
How was it?
And it was nice.
I'm thinking of doing that, but like
I left it for a year. It was so nice.
Okay.
Yeah.
I even have like a backup phone. Yeah. So that like I might not even use like I don't even before I put it in.
The only thing I'm waiting to do nice so that I'll not use WhatsApp for a year.
I don't have.
I just open WhatsApp.
I don't have.
It might be next year though. I'm feeling a vibe that it might be next year. I will just not use WhatsApp for a year.
That's going to be hard. How in that
so contract? Hard.
Email.
It's just going to be email and Telegram. Email and Telegram. Telegram is just the same as WhatsApp now. But this is the thing with WhatsApp. WhatsApp does this more of this.
Yeah, you know, most people like there's status WhatsApp. On WhatsApp. There is
so many things on WhatsApp.
So many groups on WhatsApp.
Because I stopped Telegram. Using Twitter for a month though. I stopped using Twitter for a month. Okay. Yeah, the Twitter thing I felt it because I use Twitter a lot. Like I use Twitter for my daily news. If I want to know what's going on in Nigeria, I just open Twitter. If I want to laugh, I open Twitter. If I want to hear sensible people talk, I open Twitter. So I was so addicted. So by the time I stopped for a month, it was so obvious in my life that I had so much time to do so many things.
To do other things. Taking social media breaks are actually cool. Very cool.
Yeah.
I think I'm going to try it. I might even make a video.
Social media breaks keep your mental health stable, guy. I won't lie to you. This is the thing. When NSAS was happening, I had to stay off Twitter because I could not imagine. Like, I kept seeing people die, people were dying, and they were making videos, people were showing it, how bad the country was. Like, I was just trying to keep hope in Nigeria, and at some point, I just totally lost hope in the country. And that was not positive for me at all. Like, that was not my kind of person. I'm this kind of person to always keep hope alive. So, by then, I could not do that anymore. I was so bothered about myself. So, I just started reading more stuff about Nigeria. I started working on my mental health, and then I got better, you know. I got better, and I got back on Twitter, hope alive, and kept going.
I think I logged off at some point. I think that point, so like I logged off. I made a YouTube video after it, and then I went off again for a while, but like those were terrible times.
Yeah,
but like we have to keep the hope alive.
So if we've been able to like say something in this particular episode, it's just to keep your mental health and drink water.
There's no water inside
of it. So yeah, keep your mental health stable, drink water, stay happy and shejeje, man. Stay your lane.
Like, do your thing. Just to like add to what Timmy said, I feel like if you feel like you have so many things on your plate and like your mind is getting cluttered and you just want to free yourself of the mental stress, you should just think of like, just focus on one thing.
Yeah.
One thing that you feel like once you do that thing,
something you have control
over. Once you
over.
Attack it, like something you can control, and like once you do it, you know that yes, I'm very relaxed and like everything is going to be kind of settled. Like everything becomes unnecessary once you do that one thing.
Yeah.
And most of the time, that's what like we fail to look at.
It's how to like focus on one thing at a time. You can't be at multiple places at the same time. It has to be one place. One time, one moment, try and fix that one, control that one. Then others, while you're doing that one, you can have them subconsciously, okay, that what can I do? How can I make my stuff? And you can also be like me. I solve issues in my mind before I start actualizing them. This is what I'm saying. I do this kind of sit down in my mind, okay, this is the problem to this one. What's the solution? If I did this, I did this, I did this, I did this, I did this. Okay? Next problem, this is. So three problems I've been solved in my mind. So by then I just start doing them. The energy is there. I just hit it. I know what to do.
Straight to the point. You can't be everywhere.
You're not God.
You can't be everywhere. You're not being present. So, like, what matters most? Attack that thing first. Do what you're meant to do. Have a priority list and have a not to do list so that, like, you will know that you can't be found at this particular point. Like how Tim said, you can't see him everywhere because there are some things he does not do.
It doesn't cross my mind.
Have know yourself. Say, okay, this I'm never going to go towards this place. And
yeah, there are some stuff like delegate because I live, so I delegate. I can't be everywhere. It's not possible. So
and also, you should know, like you know that people say it a lot. It's cliche, but like I'm just going to say, you know that ball like your. Think of your life like you're juggling different balls, and like there are some balls that you can leave to bounce on the floor, and then you catch them back and continue.
Yeah,
and there are
balls.
Some balls that.
What wrong with you?
I hope balls. Not to cut this part out.
What? You're getting balls and balls.
And then they're like.
And then
there are some balls which are glass, which once you drop them, like your health, there are some aspects of your life, like your health and relationships that sometimes when you drop them, they shatter, like, and it's very hard to like
don't drop that ball.
So like don't drop the ball.
No way that damn shit. That stuff. Jesus Christ. Oh God, you guys are in the progress, man.
Who said?
I mean, I was just trying to do this with some good advice, and next time it's balls and balls and balls.
Timmy, this is your reputation.
Can you imagine? My reputation is at stake. This guy is trying to ruin my reputation.
I might just help you and like cut it out, but like I don't know whether you cut it out.
I don't know, man. I'm not keeping it straight, man. I sell stuff, that kind of stuff, man. I don't monetize my podcast, so people can hear everything. Your filthy thoughts and your filthy comments. Can you imagine?
Like
nonsense.
We all know who started thinking that way when I was trying to like explain a simple life concept. But that's why
it wasn't a life concept where it keeps saying balls and balls. But then I think we've tried to make sense today. I mean, makes sense.
Like, okay, sometimes I make a video that like 1 hour and I cut it in like 7 minutes.
I wanted to ask you, can you use any kind of song you want to use for your videos?
Me? No. I have
monetized your.
No, but like YouTube is going to put it as a copyright strike. And like, when I end up monetizing it, the money is going to be going to that person.
Oh, wow.
So like, what's the point of like my hard work?
No, just keep going.
Oh,
all right,
fish.
No, swish.
Oh, okay.
Just keep going. No matter what happens, no matter the tide, no matter the current coming at you, just keep going. Like, stop trying to like fix the problem one at a time. Just don't leave your problem unfixed. Don't leave issues unattended to, but at the same time, don't stop there. Just
don't let them weigh you down.
Yeah, there was a time something really, like, my mental health was really at stake. I don't know why we're going back to this mental health again. My mental health was really at stake because I made a podcast and I did this private screening thing. First time I was doing this in my life.
Okay.
And I got some reviews that, like, made me not want to even put it out again. And it took me, like, I think 2 weeks before I finally put it out.
When you put it out, like, wait, I listened to this, like, a long time ago. Why you just uploading it?
I started doubting myself that, because the comment was so harsh. Like, I was just trying to, like, change, you know, was it that bad? Like, it was so harsh. And maybe the person was just trying to be honest, but at the same time, it was just really downcasting. Yes. And it has even really affected the whole year, because I'm not even putting the kind, like, last year was every week now.
Yeah.
And now, like, it was just one I put out in the whole of January. And this whole February itself, I've not even put out anything.
Put out this one.
Can't even make February. It's never possible.
You can make February. You can do it.
So the only thing, it affected me a lot. And now I'm putting I went from putting out stuff every week to putting out stuff every month. Like, I can't even stress again. Like, it really affected me.
I think you should go back to every, like, I feel the people who talked, do they do what you do?
No, they don't actually. That's in,
and they don't really know
what, how much it takes to, like,
the,
put out
the time,
stuff,
the energy, everything.
Like,
so, like,
say my energy is low in me. In energy, God, I am you. I felt so bad for weeks.
Curtis energy is low, but look at
come on, like, man. Like,
the people who connect with your podcast, who connect with your craft, connect with your stuff, they will connect. And those people who are not for you would look at you and be like, what's this one doing?
Exactly.
I don't like this person's vibe, and they'll go their own way.
Exactly. So just keep going, man. Like, I don't know, maybe by March I'll be able to, like, start keeping up my energy again and, like, start doing my stuff again. but then, like, please, just keep going, alright? Me doing this is just trying to, like, get back on track and, like, start doing stuff again. Because when I started doing stuff, you know, someone actually reached out to me that, like, he was really sad one day and, like, he just, the only energy he had left was just scrolling through his phone and then he just played my podcast. And then I was able to make him laugh. I was able to make him see life from a different perspective. And he had energy to, like, get us back again, and, like, get back.
We never really know whose life we are
exactly
touching.
Exactly. And
so try not to discourage us.
Please, it means a lot to creative people when you, like, talk about their work. So please don't say trash. Just try and, like, have sense and just talk small, and, like, give constructive criticism.
Yeah.
Like, okay, you can get better at this, you're doing this. Like, constructive
this thing was
criticism
not so good. You can
exactly.
Look at
not like them that sometimes. My energy is low. And my energy is low. Okay.
That's so demoralizing.
Like, I feel like my energy now actually becomes low. Like, I don't just want to do anything again. Like, wow, my energy is low now. So, I mean, you guys should not expect anything from me again. Exactly. So, please, what I'm trying to do is that, like, just trying to encourage someone out there, like, just keep going, man. I'm telling you, soon enough, people that appreciate your craft, people that appreciate your work, they will actually come. And stay in your lane, man. You can't do everything. There was a time I was trying to see if I can start making pictures the way you do. You know this thing where you make, like, with your name on it, with stuff like that. I've been trying to transfer into Instagram, trying to do that thing. And even though it will still work out,
it takes a bit of time.
Once you get the hang of it, you understand how it works. And it takes time. Give yourself time. Just keep going at it. It takes time. I've been trying to study how it does it and how you're able to connect with people, but it takes time. That's what I found out. It takes time.
Do you know Selim King?
Yeah.
You know Selim
King?
I just finished reading his book this morning
and
like the book on community, and he was like, you have to know who you are for.
Yeah.
And like you have to know who you are so that you should start with who you are.
Yeah.
And know that you are you are building something. It's not as if you just build it in one
exactly
day.
Exactly. Rome was not built in a day. Rome was not built in a day. That's how you say it now. Exactly.
That's what they say.
Yes.
I'm not the quote person.
Exactly. Rome was not built in a day. Exactly. So if you're trying to, like, get stuff done, know that it will take time. Alright? Some of our guys, you know, the Source Club, they started up their their podcast, and I was so excited when they started. Yeah, you know that like... podcasting is actually was not common on campus
at all before, at all.
And now it seems like damn, everybody's doing podcasts, and I feel like I even influenced it a bit. Make I give myself credit.
Like, it was like when I see like, okay, now I know on
people not doing podcasts before
in the whole campus right now. I know like there are three YouTubers that I know, and I'm like, I'm really impressed because like they are the ones giving me ginger right now. Like,
good, man.
Jimmy and. Okay, Ten is writing exams now, but like, she uploads a lot, so like, and I'm just like, oh, why am I chilling and not uploading anything?
Isema vlogs everything, man. Like, she even did one for Valentine's, not I was in that one too.
Oh, she, she told me she's just vlogging, but like, she's on a break. So
yeah,
like,
she's vlogging a lot.
When she comes back,
gathering content. I was on one of these stuffs and we're able to work together. But that's what I'm trying to say, like. You see that slowly you're influencing people. Podcasting, when I started, you know, people were asking me what's a podcast. And now people are beginning to relate to it. Because I found out that when I started podcasting, it wasn't until I started checking out for other podcasts, I found out that podcast was actually really... when I watched God Friended Me, actually, that I knew that, okay, podcast. Okay, there's something called podcast. Like, but by the time I started making it, now people are now like... vibing with stuff like, okay, well, I don't want to go full YouTube, let me just start with podcast because I don't have location, let me just start doing the podcast. Do you understand? So
it's easier, it's like just talk, right? But just start with what you have if you want to start anything.
Exactly.
I think we should be ending this right here.
I mean, we move now,
we move.
We stay GG.
Bye.
So for real, it was nice being on this YouTube channel. I mean, it had to happen at some point, and then like, it was nice having you on my podcast. You know,
I'm so grateful that this could work out. Like,
I mean,
it makes me feel like I should start a podcast YouTube channel. It was sort of weird.
It's so nice.